Hey, great morning, friends. Here we're with Chapter 5, Section 2, looking at X and Y intercepts. Now, the word intercept is just a term that we use to indicate where a line crosses both the X axis, your horizontal left and right axis, and your vertical up and down Y axis. So the point at which your line crosses the horizontal, the x-axis, is known as your x-intercept. Now, that's a numerical value. What point? Is it to the right of the origin, a positive x-intercept, or is it to the left, a negative x-intercept? Likewise, with your y-intercept, is it above the origin? Is it positive, or is it below negative? So, a couple things to note here with x and y intercepts. First, if you're looking to find the x-intercept, again, that is the point at which your line crosses the x-axis. If you think of that as an ordered pair, notice any point on the x-axis, 1 to the right of 0 is the point 1, 0, 2, 0, 3, 0, 4, 0, and so on. Notice the second coordinate, x, y, is always equal to 0 on the x-axis. So we're going to note that. Y is equal to 0. Conversely, if we look at the y-intercept, the point at which a line crosses your vertical axis, any point here on the y-axis, you go 0 left or right, you only move up or down. So it's like 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3. So any point on the y-axis, your y-intercept, will always have a x value that is 0. We're going to use that when we look to compute x and y-intercepts algebraically. Before we do that, we're going to take a look at a graph, actually two graphs here, and identify what the x and y-intercepts are from the graph. So my first graph, notice here I have an x-intercept that is right here. So this x-intercept is 1, 2, 3 units to the right of 0. So I would say the x-intercept is 3. The y-intercept, the point at which this line crosses the y-axis here, is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 below 0. So the y-intercept would be negative 5. That's all there is to it. Second graph here, before we look at algebraic calculations, the x-intercept is 1, 2, 3, 4 to the left of 0, so the x-intercept is negative 4, and the y-intercept, again, is below 0, so it'll be 1 below, 2 below, y-intercept of negative 2. We'll be back shortly with algebraic calculations. We're back, ready to look at the first two examples for finding x and y intercepts algebraically and then sketching a quick graph. So here's where we're going to note in finding first the x-intercept of an equation that I'm going to plug in 0 for y in order to find the x-intercept. So wherever I see a y, here it is right next to the 5, 4x plus 5 times 0 will equal 20. 5 times 0 is 0. I'm left with 4x equals 20. Dividing by 4, I'm going to get an x-intercept is positive 5. So if I think about the graph of that point, again, it doesn't have to be a work of art, but just a little sketch. An x-intercept of 5 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to the right. So I'm now going to find the y-intercept by plugging in 0 for x. So I see 0 right next, or the x, where I'll plug in 0 right next to the number 4. I'll go 4 times 0 plus 5y equals 20. 4 times 0 is 0. I'm left with 5y is 20. Dividing by 5, I get a y-intercept of positive 4. So a y-intercept of 4 is up 1, up 2, up 3. So my line then is going to go through these two points. So there is a sketch of the graph of that equation, finding both the x and the y intercept. Take a look at example 2, and then we'll end with 3 and 4. Same process here. Example 2, I'll find the x-intercept by setting y equal to 0. So there's my y right next to the minus 9. Plugging in 0 for y. 6x minus 9 times 0 is 72. Negative 9 times 0 is 0. 6x is 72. Dividing by 6, I get the x-intercept is 12. If you're using the graph paper, you might want to make every line worth 2 units. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Or if you went by 2s, of course, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, you'd go 6 units to the right. Now we'll find the y-intercept by putting in 0 for x. So I'll go 6 times x is 0. 72. 6 times 0 is 0. I'm left with negative 9y is 72. Dividing by negative 9 to undo the multiplying, I get a y-intercept is negative 8. So y-intercept of negative 8 will tell me to go down 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. My line then will be we'll be back for examples 3 and 4. Look at the final two examples. You might be thinking, well, there's more stuff on the bottom of the note sheet. We are going to skip over that. Again, we're looking to be efficient, cover the necessaries, and we will touch on the horizontal and vertical lines at another time. So we're going to continue here, finding x and y intercepts, and then sketching graphs. This is question number 18 from your assignment. Now, the reason I'm doing this one is because I do not have all of my like terms together here, and you might be thinking, whoa, I got y's on both sides of the equation. So if you can put terms together, again, if they are the same variables, it might be easier to do that. So I'm going to subtract 2y from both sides. Negative 2 minus 2, I'll have negative 4y. Plus x will equal negative 8. So now I can find the x-intercept by plugging in y is 0. So I'll have negative 4 times 0 plus x is equal to negative 8. Negative 4 times 0 is 0, and I'm just left with x-intercept is equals negative 8. So that graph, x-intercept of negative 8 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 to the left of 0. My y-intercept, again, I'll set x equal to 0. I'm going to do that in my surgically improved equation. So I'll plug in 0 for x here. Negative 4y plus 0 equals negative 8. Negative 4y equals negative 8. Dividing by negative 4, I get a y-intercept of positive 2. So I'll go up 1, up 2. And my line sketch will look like that. Again, this was question number 18 from your assignment today, if you want to kill two stones with one bird. Example 4, looking at this one here, notice it is in function form, y equals, totally fine. If I want to find the x-intercept, I'm going to put y equal to 0. So I'm going to have 0 equals negative 2x plus 5. To get x alone, I'll have to add 2x. 2x equals 5. dividing by 2. 5 divided by 2 is not a whole number. It's 2.5. So x-intercept of 2.5. That tells me to go 2.5 units to the right. So I got 1, 2, 3. There's 2.5. And we'll find the y-intercept by setting x equal to 0. So I'll plug in 0 right next to the negative 2. Negative 2 times 0 plus 5. Negative 2 times 0 is 0. Y-intercept is 5. So that tells me to go up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Two intercepts. I'm going to give them a little connection and extend with the line. You are set to go for section 5.2.